Shri Gananatham. Shri Gananatham bhajamyaham. Shri Gananatham bhajamyaham. Shri Karam Chintitartha Paladam. Shri Gananatham bhajamyaham. Shri Karam Chintitartha Paladam. Shri Gananatham. Shri Guru Guha Grajam. Shri Guru Guha Grajam Agrapujam. Shri Guru Guha Grajam Agrapujam. Shri Kantatmajam Shrita Samrajam. Shri Guru Guha Grajam Agrapujam. Shri Kantatmajam Shrita Samrajam. Shri Gananatham bhajamyaham. Shri Karam Chintitartha Paladam. Shri Gananatham bhajamyaham.
I feel extremely blessed and fortunate to be a small part of this great project by my good friend Sri Srinivasa Murthy. He's a great collector of good music and great music. And in this collection, we get to enjoy 21 extraordinary recordings by Dr. Balamurli Krishna on Lord Ganesha. Sri Srinivasa Murthy has titled it an iconic collection, and that is absolutely true, because the singer Dr. Balamurli Krishna, he's an icon. Many of his accompanists like Sri M.S. Gopalakrishnan, Sri T.V. Gopalakrishnan, who are featured here, they are icons in their own right. The composers of these songs are icons like Saint Tyagaraja, Sri Muthuswami Dikshitir, Maharaja Swadhi Thirunal, Sri Purandara Dasa, and of course Dr. Balamurli Krishna himself, not to mention others like Mysore Vasudevacharya. Then of course the greatest icon is Lord Ganesha himself, who is such a beloved presence in Hindu culture. Dr. Balamurli Krishna, when we think of him among the Hindu gods, we might think of Lord Krishna first. Firstly because of his name, secondly because his signature is Murali, thirdly because of his multifaceted genius, and fourthly because of an element of mischief which we find in Lord Krishna also. But Dr. Balamurli Krishna was very, very close to Lord Ganesha, and he has made a whole array of compositions ranging from a varnam to several kritis and even a mangalam on Lord Ganesha. Normally we feature a composition on Lord Ganesha right at the beginning of a concert, but here we get to enjoy firstly a padavarnam by Dr. Balamurli Krishna himself in raga Kharahara Priya on Lord Ganesha, where in some of the charanams he explores very, very rare and special stories connected to Ganesha. For example, the story of how the city of Varanasi was attacked by an asura, a demon called Durasara, and how Ganesha thwarted his bad intentions. This is his own composition, Balamurli Krishna's own composition, where very beautifully he says, Varanasi nakraminchina, the person who attacked Varanasi, Durasaruni Durasa Nirasa Gavimpa. He says he converted Durasa's Durasa, the bad intention, to disappointment. Like that, each charanam is a classic. I can go on talking about just this varnam for a very long time, but I want you to listen to the other compositions also. The second song is in Raga Bangala by Saint Tyagaraja. This is a very, very, very special recording, and I had the privilege of being physically present when this was done. This was in around the year 2008-2009, when Balamurlikrishna sir had a private recording session of a whole set of kritis by Saint Tyagaraja. Here he sang Giriraja Sutta Tanaya first, after which he himself accompanied the recording with a viola and later with a mridangam. This is probably the last time he did that. And as the years progressed, you find that his voice, the clarity of his enunciation, the aesthetic sense, everything just became sharper and sharper. And this is a very, very rare and precious recording. And as a contrast, the third song is all the way back from 1960s, early 60s, a rare composition by Mysore Vasudevacharya in Hamsadhwani, Vande Nishamaham, where Balamurli sir is accompanied by Sri M.S. Gopalakrishnan and T.V. Gopalakrishnan. They were his standard accompanists those days. And this entire set of 21 recordings, we hear Hamsadhwani again and again. But each time, unlike a raga like Todi, which can be very, very versatile, Hamsadhwani is much more limited, but still each time we get to experience a different facet of the raga. And the first Hamsadhwani is in this composition. Number 4 is Mahadeva Sutam in Arabhi, which is Balamurli sir's own composition, where among other things he makes a very salient point. Edi korina evari japinchina adiga ninnu adigina nadu. He says, whoever we pray to, at first we have to pray to Ganesha. It is like Ganesha is saying, if you are a devotee of Krishna and you pray to him and Krishna is busy, he may not look at you. The same goes with Shiva and all the others. But you come to me first, even if you are a Shiva devotee, even if you are a Krishna devotee, you come to me first, then if your hero is busy, I will take care of you. That's the idea. The composition number 5 is of course the very classic Sri Ganapatini by Saint Tyagaraja, where Tyagaraja visualizes magnificent Ganesha in a happy mood dancing. And the whole spirit of the composition, of course, he is a heavyweight dancer, which is described in the song, Ghana Tarambuganu Mahipai Padamulu. When heavily he stomps his feet on the earth, Kallu Kallan, Kallu Kallana Nunchi. So that is the sound of the anklets. And he dances in Vivitha Gatula, several rhythmic variation, Dhittalangumani, which is very rare for Saint Tyagaraja. It's a very, very beautiful composition where we can really visualize the scene of Ganesha dancing the way Dr. Balamurlikrishna sings this. After this comes Hamsadhwani number 2, Pari Pari Ni Padame Bhavana. Always I think of your feet. That is a composition in Telugu by Dr. Balamurlikrishna himself, accompanied by Sri M. Chandrasekharan and Sri Dandamudi Ram Mohan Rao. This is from 1982. So the speciality with this collection is that just like Dr. Balamurlikrishna's amazing voice could just jump to any note in all the three octaves, this collection of recordings jumps from early 1960s till around 2010, giving us a very beautiful panorama of the composer's and the singer's personality over the decades. And the seventh composition is Uma Sutam Namami from 1980s, which is a three-note composition. It has Shadjam, Madhyamam and Panchamam. But here Balamurli sir demonstrates that in the hands of a capable person like him, even with three notes, one could do a respectable round of improvisation in the form of swaram singing. The next is a composition by Maharaja Swati Tirunal in the raga Saveri. This remains the only available song by Maharaja on Lord Ganesha, Paripahi Ganathipa. After this comes a very beautiful song by Balamurli sir himself, Pahi Prabhu, in Hamsadhuni again. This is from a 1970s American tour, accompanied by Annavarapu Ramaswamy and Tanjavur Upendran. Then comes Pancha Matanga Mukha Ganapatina, which is a very, very, very beautiful mood-creating composition in Raga Malahari by Muthuswami Dikshitir. Dr. Balamurli Krishna remains one of the few who sang Malahari as Malahari without bringing in Saveri to it. And this remained one of his perpetual favorites. After that comes a very beautiful song in Arabhi, Sri Sakala Ganathipa. I have a special affinity with this song because the original was Sri Ramana Vibho in Raga Arabhi by Maharaja Swadi Tirunal. Balamurli sir liked that tune so much that he composed his own composition in the same tune. And the specialty is that in this song, the Pallavi is on Lord Ganesha, the Anupallavi on Sri Hanuman, and the Charanam on Lord Krishna. So he would joke that there are so many Raga Malikas, but this is in the same Raga, but it is a Deva Malika. After this comes Pirai Aniyum Piruman Maidane, which is the Tamil version of Pari Pari Ni Padame in Telugu, in Hamsadhuni. In both, he has this beautiful imagery of Lord Ganesha standing behind those who stand in front of him with folded hands. It's a very beautiful image. After that comes a vintage early 1960s recording in Raga Nate. Here one can notice how his enunciation of the lyrics has changed over the decades, because many Carnatic musicians, they find it difficult to close their mouth. For example, if we sing Siddhi Vinayakam, many people would not close the mouth and say Siddhi Vinayakam or something like that. So here in Ganathipam, that old pronunciation, we can still find traces of that, which completely vanished by the late 1970s. And Balamurli Krishna in this collection, he surprises us by singing a Ragam Tanam Pallavi on Ganesha in Raga Hamsadhani. This is during the 1970s. Next comes a very strange and dissonant Raga, which is his own creation, called Sumukham. It has Sajjam, the third Rishabham, Pratimathyamam, and the Kakali Nishadam, which is very, very strange. I used to tell him that people gave you this label of being postmodern and whatever because of ragas like this. Then comes the evergreen Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajeham with another style and another set of amazing swarams. We find that in most of these recordings, even in the last round of very elaborate swarams, he gives the violinist a chance to play solo also, which with a person like M.S. Gopalakrishnan playing violin, the singer has to be supremely confident that he can hold his own, because the violinist can be so amazing. In fact, when we listen to Balamurli sir singing and M.S. Gopalakrishnan playing, we wonder who got influenced more by whom, because the influence of each other is so, so obvious and so beautiful. Then comes one of his last compositions, one of his latest compositions, which is a four-note raga called Siddhi. Siddhim Dehi Me. This was recorded in just before 2010. After that comes another three-note raga, which I have a small hand in, because once I was giving a lecture demonstration on Balamurli sir's compositions, and at that time only Uma Sutam existed as a three-note raga, which he first called Sarvasri and later changed it to Trishakti, the power of three. So I told him again and again, I've been talking about this three-note raga, so why don't you compose one more three-note raga perhaps. And the next day itself, when I went to his house, and he was very happy, he had a mischievous glint in his eye, and he said, I have something for you, like that. And he made this song, Gam Ganapatim, and the raga, he named it Ganapati, which is very apt now for celebrating Vinayaka Chaturthi. There in the Charanam, the letter 3, because it's a three-note raga, the letter 3 just keeps coming. Tribhuvana sarvam tvat swarupam trikala moolam triloka deepam shubhakara murali gana lapam siddhi buddhi santosha kalapam. It's a very, very beautiful charanam. And the last but one song is by Sangeeta Pitamaha, Sri Purandara Dasa, where he has tuned it in a ragamalika with ragas like Kamas, Kamavardhini, Sudhasaveri and Saveri. Again, it's very rare to hear a ragamalika on Lord Ganesha. And finally, the recording finishes with Mangalam, composed by Balamurli sir himself in Shuruti. So it's such an amazing collection, and the number 21 is very significant to Lord Ganesha, which is why Sri Srinivasa Murthy has made a compilation like this. The only sad thing is that I wish instead of 21, the number 100 was Ganesha's favorite number. Then we could have had many more songs like this, which of course will keep coming in Srinivasa Murthy sir's YouTube channel. There are so many things I could talk about each of these compositions, but because of paucity of time, I don't want my explanation to be longer than the Ragam Tana Pallavi. But I take this opportunity to wish all lovers of good music a very, very happy Vinayaka Chaturthi.
Ranjita Nataka Rangato Shanam Sinjita Varamani Maya Bhushanam Ranjita Nataka Rangato Shanam Sinjita Varamani Maya Bhushanam Anjaneya Avataram Subhashanam Anjaneya Avataram Subhashanam Kunjara Mukham Tyagaraja Poshanam Shri Gananadham Bhajamyagam Shrikaram Chintitartha Phaladam Shri Gananadham Bhajamyagam.